Hi, I'm Dr. Christine Horner, and today we're going to talk about hormones. We hear so much about hormones. Every day there's a new book about it and people specializing in hormones. So what in the heck are they? So hormones are actually little tiny amounts of, we're going to call them cholesterol-based. Believe it or not, that's why we need to have cholesterol in our diet, because they're based on the cholesterol molecule, but they're extremely potent and they have effects all over our bodies. So the key ones that we are familiar with is the feminine hormone estrogen. Believe it or not, men have estrogen too. The male hormone, testosterone, and believe it or not, women have testosterone too. We just have them in different balances. So these particular molecules are things that have tremendous amounts of actions in our body. So for instance, estrogen is something that gives us the female characteristics. It even determines our voice, breast development, our menstrual periods, all the different qualities that we see in a woman, the bone quality, the facial skeleton, all of those things are influenced by estrogen. Likewise, testosterone for a man is something that dictates its secondary sex characteristics, is kind of the medical term that we use. So it's hair distribution, the lower voice, the musculature, the bigger jaws, the Adam's apple, all the things that we see that are characteristically in men versus in women. Now there's lots of other hormones that we have, and the thing that becomes very complicated is that when hormones are formed, another hormone can be formed out of a different hormone. So for instance, when our kidneys, that's one of the major manufacturing areas, our adrenal glands that sit on top of our kidneys, produces certain hormones called androsterones. And so these things will be converted then into estrogens and even into testosterone. So one of the kind of tricky things about taking external hormones is that you never know if they're going to stay that way, because our body has these ways to convert them into other hormones. Progesterone is another one that we hear a lot about and is dictated as far as being helpful in lowering the risk of breast cancer and helping with menopausal symptoms. But none of it's ever that simple. So there's other studies that will show that progesterone, for example, is something that can actually increase the risk of developing breast cancer. So our views of hormones sometimes are too simplistic, and this is why I'm very cautionary about taking external hormones, which has become very popular today, because it's very, very complex. We're never going to understand it all, and everything is interrelated with everything else. So we can't control exactly how much we're going to have. My approach to making sure that you have the best hormone levels for you as an individual at your age is by enhancing your own body's inner healing intelligence. In Ayurveda, we look at the body like a tree. So giving yourself hormones is like out there chopping at the leaves and pruning at the leaves, whereas enhancing your body's inner healing intelligence through proper diet and lifestyle is like watering the roots. It will make sure that your internal healing intelligence, which is smarter than any of us doctors are, will have your hormone levels exactly what they need to be for you as an individual at your age. So if you have any questions about this or any other health question, just click on the link below. I'd love to answer your questions.